Good afternoon from the Polynesian Village. I'm excited to be back. We haven't stayed here in a while.
Yeah, I don't remember the last time.
I don't know either. It's been a little while though. Last time we stayed here, there was a lot that wasn't open. Pretty much everything's open here again, so that's exciting. The resort officially opened, I think, a week ago? A week and a half ago? Something like that?
It was the 19th, right?
I don't know. Something like that. So it is open now. The new port coaster that they built is open, so the Magical Express drops you off. You can drop off guests or anything at the front, but the entrance is not done. So it's all still ripped up. There is no monorail station yet, but it's rumored to be done sometime mid-August. So they're getting close. It's just not finished. So when we go in the lobby later, we'll show that the main doors are still sealed off. But the new Moana rooms have opened for the normal resort. So we're still at the villas, but the Moana rooms have opened up. Ohana's open, which we have gone to since it reopened, and it was still good. I do miss some of the food they used to have. Like the food on the skewers used to be
it was okay.
But it was still good. Of course, skewers would not be sanitary right now, so it was fine, but still tasty. And Trader Sam's opened a week ago, or a little over a week ago now, and I haven't been yet, so we're going today.
Well, same. I've never been inside ever.
I've been inside, I think, once or twice, but we go out on the patio all the time before Trader Sam's closed, but we very rarely go indoors. You've walked in there, but never
I peeked my head in, but yeah. I was scared because I didn't know if I was going to get in trouble.
Oh, right, because after 8 p.m. it's 21 and up, so we are going to go there tonight, get our name on the wait list. We don't have a dining reservation, so we're just going to eat at Captain Cook's. But I'm excited. It's my favorite resort, so we wanted to come here for my birthday. And really, I just want to go to Trader Sam's. So we're going to go. Of course, it's 3:30. We still never got a room text because that doesn't really seem to work anymore.
Yep.
So we're going to go get a room number from the lobby and then head to the room. We were walking over to the Great Ceremonial House, and then I checked my Disney Experience because it wasn't working in the parking lot. And it finally loaded, and we did just literally get our room number. So we are on the second floor of Moorea because we have a Seven Seas Lagoon view.
We're always on the first floor. At least
we are.
When I've been here with you.
Yeah, we always get the first floor. And I kind of thought we would again, so I'm a little excited.
Yeah.
Because it'll be a nicer view being a little up in the air. And then, yeah, I don't know if we're going to swim. It's really hot out. I don't know what we're going to do, but at least we can drop our stuff off at the room now. So it looks like there's some construction going on here. At Moorea, which we did read that they were refreshing the rooms here, and some people are getting moved to Moana rooms, but it looks like we're still in the villas. Welcome to our deluxe studio here at the Polynesian. First up, we have a connecting door here on the left, which has a handicap button, which is pretty cool. So I'm wondering if there's an accessible room.
Might be.
Then there's a closet right here. And then the first bathroom. So the Polynesian villas are a little different because they have two. So this one is the large bathroom with the shower tub. And then some fun mermaid artwork. And handheld, or the little tubes of toiletries, which is rare to find. Then we have the little kitchenette right here. So we have a coffee maker, mini fridge, microwave, everything that we normally have, a little toaster in the corner. And then we have the second shower. So this is kind of the advantage because these villas can have up to 5 people. You can have 2 people getting ready in the morning. So you have the rainfall shower here with the big walk-in shower, and then another sink as well to get ready. Just no toilet in this bathroom. And then the main room. So we have the bed here, which I'm trying to decide. I feel like they already may have updated this room a little bit because I feel like those curtains are new. But I could be imagining that.
I don't remember orange curtains.
No, and they have those weird handles. So they must have already, because they said it was a, I forget how the phrase was that I read online, that they were doing a linen refresh or something. But then they have the Murphy bed right here, which I think has Stitch on it. Yep, Lilo and Stitch. And then, of course, my favorite lamp that I have at home of Maui. And then the pull-out sofa as well. Overall, the room looks pretty much the same, but I do feel like they may have already updated it because you have the orange curtain with this crazy large handle for pulling it closed, and then the green curtain, green blackout curtain with the same handle. But we have a great view The only possible view that would have been better is if we were on the third floor. But this is definitely better than being up on, or being down on floor one, because you can see much more of the castle.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So that's a really cool view of it. Then you have Space Mountain, of course. We can see a good portion of the Tron canopy, which shows you just how wide it is from here.
I see a Big Thunder to the left.
Oh, yeah. Kind of see Big Thunder a little bit over the bungalows. And then you can see a little bit of Contemporary over there. And I'm sure if we went on the balcony, oh yeah, you can even see it from here. You can see a little bit of Grand Floridian kind of through the trees. So definitely a very fun view. And it's always cool looking out at the bungalows. But yeah, I'm very happy that we are on the second floor this time. So Amanda's cracked the code and we just sat down and we're thinking about it. I don't think these are like replacement handles for the villas. I think, like Amanda pointed out, this is probably because we're in a handicap room.
I also noticed that the bed is kind of lower than usual, so it's probably
There's so many little differences that I'm just like slowly picking up on, so the bed is definitely lower, because I think typically you have room to put your suitcase under it.
But because of the nightstand next to it, it's kind of high up.
It is very tall, so yeah, the nightstands are probably the normal height, and you can see the difference in the height of the bed, so that's super interesting. Oh, and there's little outlets and USB ports, that's fun. But Amanda just noticed that we don't even have sliding balcony doors. We have a legit door that opens, and like this balcony is much larger than your typical balcony.
Yeah.
So if I go stand at this end, it goes pretty far down. That's like easily the size of a balcony we've had at one bedroom.
In a wheelchair or something, they're gonna have to have room.
Yeah, they need the room for the wheelchair over there.
And also, if it's sliding, if there's like a little bump that's over, so if it's
No, it makes sense. But that's so cool. I've never had a normal door on a balcony before. It's very interesting.
Maybe we won't get locked out this time.
And then here's our view again, but now from the actual outdoors. It's so hot out. And then the other thing that I quickly kind of wanted to mention, which will probably be more obvious later, there has been a change in Disney policy again since the last time we were here, and that is that indoor, anytime you go indoors, you have to wear a mask again, whether that be, you know, going into the hotels or the parks. Anytime you're in a store, a restaurant, the mask has to go on, as well as any attractions and transportation. I believe the only exception for transportation might be the boat, because it specifically said enclosed transportation, and that does include the monorail, the buses, the Skyliner. But anytime you enter a ride, whether it's indoors or outdoors, you are required to wear a mask again due to the rising case count here in Florida. Can't tell if people are wearing them over on the ferry boat, so I'm not positive about that one. Oh, you can see Wilderness Lodge back there too, that's fun.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
That's cool. But yeah, I did want to point that out because, I mean, we were already wearing our masks again anyway, so if you watched our Riviera video, that was before the requirement was put in place and we were already wearing them. But we will have our masks on later when we go into Captain Cook's and into Trader Sam's and everything, because it is a requirement once again. For the time being. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's terrifying. The one thing that I don't like about the bungalows is how loud that ferry boat is when we've stayed in them. Didn't remember them being that loud, but it makes sense because you're right next to the TTC, which is literally right there. So we just placed our order for dinner at Captain Cook's, but we have 9 minutes before our arrival window opens up. So we came into one of the buildings that was redone to see what it looks like. So here's the new hallway, which definitely looks a bit different than ours. The wall looks really nice. The carpet's a lot. It looks cool. Little Moana-themed lights. It looks nice. Very tropical. And they did... Oh, I didn't even see him. That's cool.
Can you see the...
Yeah, Heart of Tahiti.
Yeah.
Oh, it's in the light as well. I can focus on it. There we go. And then outside, they actually redid the whole landscaping area that's over by Pineapple and I. So we'll go take a look at that. Okay, so we've now come over to the main area. So right here is the main pool with the volcano slide. We did actually swim earlier, but it was too crowded at this pool. So we went over to the quiet pool closer to our building. But over here is the outdoor seating for Captain Cook's. So that's where we're about to be eating. But the last time we were here, this whole area was actually behind construction walls. So there was like a wall right next to Pineapple and I, and this whole area was like inaccessible. But the wall came down back when the resort opened, and it's now this really nice new landscaping area. lots of tropical plants, which looks great. And I feel like maybe the walkway's a little bit wider. I could be wrong, but makes it a little bit easier to get back to the beach to watch Happily Ever After. And then the whole turf lawn is still here, of course. But yeah, the new plants look great. So we're just gonna head inside and wait for our arrival window for Captain Cook's. And we're also probably gonna find out how long the wait is for Trader Sam's, because we do wanna get there after dinner, depending on how long the line is. All right, so while we're waiting for our food, I also wanted to stop by the front desk because I am not wearing my magic band. I have one for the park tomorrow, but I'm not wearing it at the moment. And my phone is not working for the unlock your room thing, so I have to get a room key. But we're still collecting them anyway, so that's fine. But here is the main entrance, which is still under construction. So hopefully in another month or so, maybe a little less, this will finally be open. But they did move the front desk back into this building, which is great. So gonna get, ooh, it looks like they have Lay's, maybe we'll get those as well, which would be fun. We now got our table and our food from Captain Cook's. It did take a little while, we were very hungry. It was fine. We're like, just starving.
I think it just felt like it was longer, yeah. But I don't think it actually was.
No. But we both got the nachos that we've had before. They are incredible. So we have two orders of those. And then we couldn't remember how big it was because we shared it before when we were up at Tambu Lounge, which they actually are pretty big. But we did get an order of the Thai coconut meatballs to share as well in case we weren't full. We also talked about mobile ordering bread pudding from Kona, which I don't know if we're gonna do or not, but we joined the list for Trader Sam's. They didn't really have an estimate for how long it's gonna take, so we'll just see when we get our text.
Okay, so we've been done eating for a little while now.
Yeah.
And we're just trying to kill time.
We're just sitting here.
We already went in the store.
Twice.
I bought a hat. I don't know when our table, well, I shouldn't even say table, because we don't get a table, it's standing room.
Yeah, standing room.
So like, we don't know when it's going to be ready. I asked, and she's like, I don't know.
Yeah, she's like, I can't tell you.
But like, in the past, they've always given you an estimate on how long it's going to take. So I don't know what's going on. I really hope it's soon. It's like already 9 o'clock. It's open until midnight.
Fireworks are starting soon, so
yeah.
Maybe if it's not ready, we can watch the fireworks.
I mean, we're only two people, so like, we really don't need that much room.
Yeah, and I just feel like people in there staying there for a while. Like, is there like a time limit, like how open it was?
I don't think so.
That's probably why they can't tell.
That could be. Hopefully soon. But I've been sitting here admiring Maui. There he
is. He's taken like 100 pictures of him.
I mean, we have so much time to kill, and I just can't not. But maybe we'll watch some fireworks if it's not ready soon.
Each of us has a dream, a heart's desire. It calls to us. And when we're brave enough to listen and bold enough to pursue, that dream will lead us on a journey to discover who we're meant to be. All we have to do is look inside our hearts and unlock the magic within.
Ready to begin, let the wonder take hold.
Feel it draw you in. Watch the moment unfold.
Spark a dream that we're meant to follow. Setting out for a new tomorrow.
Every step we take brings a new hope, a new day.
Every choice we
stop.
Okay, so we got tired of waiting, so we actually went back to the room and we watched fireworks. Those were those quick little clips I put in. Didn't have any music. Of course, the music's playing over here by the Great Ceremonial House. But then halfway through the show, we got our text that Trader Sam's is ready. So we're on our way. I don't know how busy it's going to be in there. The text said we encourage people to share tables, which no thanks right now. If we have a mask requirement again, I don't think sharing tables sounds enjoyable, but they have lots of standing room, so I assume that's what we'll be doing. But I'm just excited to see it again and finally go back in Trader Sam's. So we have our table here in Trader Sam's. That was our beautiful greeting with the storm going off, but it's still fun in here. We have, of course, Aola. But yeah, we're just waiting to get our drink menu. We did get a table, which is fantastic. There's actually plenty of open seating.
Somebody ordered a Nautilus, so we are diving underwater. Amanda, what are your first impressions?
I was just about to say this is so cool.
It's the coolest thing ever. Oh wait, the octopus arm up above the bar is moving. Oh. Is it actually pouring something in the cup? I can't tell. I don't think it was, but that's hilarious. I love this bar so much. If you've never been to Trader Sam's, here's a look at the menu. So a lot of the drinks do come optional with mugs, so you can get the Nautilus, the Aoa, the Zombie, Hippopotamus Mai Tai. They can all come with mugs, or you can just get it without if you don't want to pay for it. So like the Mai Tai, for example, is 15 or 25 if you want the mug with it as well. And Trader Sam's updates them every few months to a year or so with a new glaze color, so they kind of change the addition. But I believe everything is the same as when it closed, so no new mugs at the moment. But yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna get. The Zombie is one of my favorites, and I don't think I've ever actually had the Hippopotamus Mai Tai, and I am a Mai Tai fan, so probably gonna be one of those two. The Nautilus is amazing, but it is meant for multiple people to share, and I know Amanda was considering something. Oh, you're gonna get the spiky pineapple?
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Here is my Hippopotamus Mai Tai. I missed the little effect that they did, but it was fun. And then your spiky pineapple, which I think is like a frozen drink with Dole Whip in it, I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure, yeah.
So, it should be tasty. Oh, we've got another Nautilus. Oh, the little pineapple on the back, I love it. It's so fun. It looks like somebody ordered a Hippopotamus Mai Tai, I believe. Hippos are up in the trees. This is what happened when I ordered mine.
Oh.
Oh no. Thank you. This is the one that I keep missing. It's the Krakatoa. They play a little siren and the volcano erupts. You can see it. It's a little bad angle, but somebody over there got a Krakatoa.
Good morning. It is time to check out.
Yes, it is.
Which is sad because I love Polynesian, but we're going to the parks, so that should be fun. So we're gonna start in Magic Kingdom. I don't know if there's really much we're going to like film there. So it might just be one video for the day probably.
I don't think we're gonna be eating or doing much there.
We just wanna see the big 50 that they put on the castle, because now the decorations are complete. and we figured we're staying here so we can take the boat over, which would be nice.
Yeah.
So I think that's the plan. Then we're gonna go to Epcot because we have dinner at Garden Grill tonight.
Do you think we're gonna take the Epcot monorail or not?
I kinda want to. So yeah, we might. Because then we have to take the monorail back.
At, yeah, like, that's what I was, that was the one thing I was thinking about. I was like, I don't know how that
But if go. We don't stay for the fireworks, it would probably not be too crowded. So we'll
what
see.
What time's dinner?
8:30.
Okay, so we'll probably be out before fireworks.
We could be like leaving during them, and then it wouldn't be bad. Yeah. So we'll see. Because I do want to move into the monorail since it reopened, so that would be nice. So definitely subscribe to see that video with the castle decorations and Garden Grill and maybe monorail. That'd be fun. And give this video a like if you enjoyed our visit at the Polynesian and dinner at Captain Cook's and Trader Sam's or anything. It's fun. Mm-hmm. I always love being here. But that is it for this trip. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys the next time we go to Disney and beyond.